If you find this video helpful, like it, share it. If you didn't like something or have suggestion, write in comments below. Support and subscribe SS Physics channel. The definition is like this. Bending of light across the edges of an obstacle is called as a diffraction. Or, it is the encroachment of light in the region of geometrical shadow of an obstacle. As shown in the figure, you can see there is a sharp obstacle. And when the light gets incident, obstacle will block the light. But at the edges, that is the sharp edges, the light will get diffracted or bent to some extent. So on the screen, you will see here, there is a geometrical shadow. But in the geometrical shadow, light will enter here. And that is the encroachment of the light in the geometrical shadow. There are two types of diffraction. First, Fraunhofer diffraction. In Fraunhofer diffraction, the source of the light and the screen are at infinite distance from the obstacle. You can see in this figure, the source is there, slit, screen. Source here is a point source, therefore it will give you spherical wavefront. The width of the slit is of the order of 0.1 millimeter, 0.02 millimeter, like this. So it's very small, practically. If you want to perform this Fraunhofer diffraction in laboratory, you will need two biconvex lenses because it is not practically possible to keep the source at infinite distance and the screen also at infinite distance. And therefore, we have to use two biconvex lenses as shown in the figure. So what is the purpose of these biconvex lenses? So it is like this. So we are having this point source that will emit the spherical wavefront. That spherical wavefront is converted into plane wavefront and that plane wavefront will strike on the slit. And hence, the rays will get diffracted, maybe upward or downward. So one direction here, that is angle theta, is shown here. So these diffracted rays again will get converged using a biconvex lens and these rays will get incident on the screen at point P. So at point P, you will see the resultant of all these rays. It may be a brightness, or it may be a darkness or dark point or in intermediate between the bright and dark, whatever it is. So it depends on the path difference of these rays. So hence, overall, if you see that on the screen, you will see the diffraction pattern, that is a Fraunhofer diffraction at single slit, where you will see the maximum intensity at the center, then zero intensity here, that is the minima, again then maximas and minimas and so on. Then second type of diffraction is called as a Fresnel diffraction. In this, source and the screen are at a finite distance from the obstacle. So you can see in this figure, there is no biconvex lens used. So you can perform this experiment anywhere. So you will need a point source, then you will need a slit and the screen. So source will emit a spherical or maybe sometimes cylindrical wavefront that will get incident on the slit. And again, the slit will diffract these rays. These diffracted rays will converge at point P on the screen. And here on the screen, you will see the diffraction pattern. So this is the Fresnel diffraction. Now, it is found that students get confused regarding the distances in Fraunhofer and Fresnel diffraction. So how to remember in which type of diffraction the distance is finite and in which the distance is infinite? So it's very simple. So there is a simple trick to remember this. So you see the two words, that is a Fraunhofer diffraction and then the second is the Fresnel diffraction. So which word is longer? So you can see Fraunhofer word is longer. Hence, the distances in Fraunhofer diffraction are longer or infinite. And in Fresnel diffraction, as it is a shorter word, so distances are shorter or finite. Now, we will see the difference between Fraunhofer and Fresnel diffraction. So, you can refer the figures at the bottom. So, this is a Fraunhofer and this is a Fresnel diffraction. First point, in Fraunhofer diffraction, source and the screen are at infinite distance from the slit if biconvex lenses are not used. In Fresnel diffraction, the source and the screen are at finite distance from the slit. Second point of difference, in Fraunhofer diffraction, incident wavefront on the aperture is plane. You can see, as shown in the figure, the incident wavefront is plane. And in Fresnel diffraction, the incident wavefront is spherical or cylindrical. Third point, the diffracted wavefront is plane in Fraunhofer diffraction, and in Fresnel diffraction, the diffracted wavefront is either spherical or cylindrical. In Fraunhofer diffraction, two biconvex lenses are required to study diffraction in laboratory. No lenses are required to study diffraction in the laboratory for Fresnel diffraction. In Fraunhofer diffraction, mathematical treatment is easy, and in Fresnel, the mathematical treatment is complicated. Why so? See here, in Fraunhofer diffraction, all the rays are getting incident at the same angle of incidence. Therefore, we don't have to consider their separate angle of incidences. But in Fresnel diffraction, you will see all the rays which are getting incident are having different angle of incidence, and therefore we have to consider each ray's angle of incidence, and therefore it becomes complicated to study this. Next point, Fraunhofer diffraction has many applications in designing the optical instruments, while the Fresnel diffraction has less applications in designing the optical instruments. And the last point, Fraunhofer diffraction have the maximas and minimas which are well defined, while Fresnel diffraction has the maximas and minimas which are not well defined. Now, what is the meaning of this well defined and not well defined? That can be understood using this figure. So this is a Fraunhofer diffraction intensity pattern, and this is the Fresnel diffraction intensity pattern. In both, you will see the maximas are there, but what about minimas? So in Fraunhofer diffraction, you will see the minimas are having zero intensity, or they are completely dark, and therefore the pattern here is bright dark. So high contrast pattern you will see here, and therefore we call here the maximas and minimas are well defined. But if you see the Fresnel diffraction, the minimas are not having the zero intensity, but they are having non-zero intensity, or they are having less brightness than the maximas. And therefore, resultant pattern is not like a dark bright, but it is a less bright pattern. So the contrast here is less, and therefore we call in Fresnel diffraction, the maximas and minimas are not well defined. Okay, so this is the difference between Fraunhofer and Fresnel diffraction. If you found this video helpful, please like it and subscribe to the channel for new updates and new videos. Learn more about physics from this.